The world's oceans make up around 70% of this planet, and only 5% of them have been explored. That means that the vast majority of the Earth is made up of deep, dark waters with mysteries waiting to be discovered. Even with the small amount of ocean exploration that has been completed, some incredible places, animals, and objects have been found. Searching the depths of our oceans can give us insight into the past, the present, and sometimes even the future. Exploring these areas lets us see pieces of history and gives us ideas of other things that may be lurking in the deep. Here are 10 of the most unbelievable discoveries that have been made underwater. Can you imagine what else is out there? Number 10. Atlit Yam. Ancient cities found in the depths of the sea are always intriguing, no matter how many are discovered. The ruins of Atlit Yam are 8 to 12 meters, 26 to 39 feet deep in the Mediterranean Sea off the coast of Israel. Discovered in 1984, the city is believed to belong to the Neolithic era and is one of the largest underwater settlements ever found. Exploration at Atlit Yam has produced the remains of houses, water wells, humans, and animals, as well as objects, artifacts, and mysterious structures dating back thousands of years. One of its most impressive structures is thought to be a ritual site consisting of huge stones arranged in a circle around what used to be a spring. Other interesting discoveries at Atlit Yam include a stone well used for water service and eventually as a disposal pit due to the large number of remains found inside. 65 sets of human remains were also located in and around the city, some providing the earliest known cases of tuberculosis. There were also bones of wild and domesticated animals, suggesting that those who occupied Atlit Yam both hunted and raised animals for food. By the way, scientists still haven't figured out what caused the flooding of the village. Some suggest that as the glaciers melted, the boundaries of the oceans widened and eventually the village ended up underwater. Also, there's a theory that there was a sudden powerful tsunami. We're sure that sooner or later, scientists will find the reason. After all, the village of Atlit Yam was discovered only in 1984, and not much time has passed since then. Number 9. The Lion City. You've probably heard of Atlantis, right? Well, if you haven't, it's an ancient city that disappeared underwater. Some believe that it's a myth, that others don't give up and keep on searching for it. But Atlantis is not the only underwater city on our planet. However, you don't need to search for the city we're talking about now, because its location is already known. The Lion City is located in China. Scientists also found out that this ancient installation is more than 1,300 years old, but it was submerged too, not so long ago. It happened back in 1959 when the local government completed the construction of a hydroelectric power station. As a result of the construction, the city went underwater completely, and thus a lake appeared with an area of 573 square kilometers. It's called Thousand Island Lake. We think it's strange that the government just flooded such an ancient place, but maybe there were reasons for that. Before the flooding from the city of Xicheng, which is its name in Chinese, 290,000 people were evicted. Today, this place is popular with divers from all over the world, as the city is located at a depth of only to 40 meters underwater. In addition, it's pretty well preserved, and its area is equal to the total area of 62 football fields. Number 8. Ghost Fleet Chuk Lagoon. Shipwrecks are some of the most interesting things to find in the ocean. They tell a story of another time in history, give clues about what happened and who was there, or just look cool. Chuk Lagoon is found in the Caroline Islands in the Pacific Ocean, north of New Guinea and east of the Philippines. Here, the wreckage of countless Japanese ships and aircraft was discovered, having been destroyed in World War II. The Ghost Fleet was the subject of a 1969 Jacques Cousteau film in which the wreckage was explored and the site began to be recovered. However, it is said that bodies still remain among the ships and planes, and the site itself is partially visible from the water surface. The wreckage of Japan's Imperial Fleet is an incredible example of an underwater discovery that is not only intriguing, but informational and historic as well. Number 7. Baiyi. Have you ever dreamed of visiting a place where just a few thousand years ago, such great people as Julius Caesar, Pompey, and Gaius Marius just walked around? Well, then watch carefully, because we're going to show it to you now. You can't go there, though. What you have to do there is swim. Baiae is a seaside town on the coast of the Gulf of Naples in Italy, and is impossible to say exactly when it was founded, and there is nothing remarkable in this town until Roman aristocrats suddenly fell in love with it. They noticed that Baiae was located in a very beautiful area, and stars at building their villas, theaters, and temples there. In the days of ancient Rome, Baiae was a luxurious and festive place, but today it's almost completely gone underwater. Despite the fact that the buildings are almost not preserved, today you can still find a few examples of ancient Roman architecture underwater. Descending into the waters of the Tyrrhenian Sea, divers can see these sculptures, ruins, columns, and arches built in the years BC. It's a pity that in a couple of decades they'll probably completely disappear, though. Nature does not spare anyone, and in fact, it was it that caused the flooding. Scientists agreed that the city went underwater due to volcanic activity. Number 6. City of Pavlo Petri. Discovered in 1967 by Dr. Nick Fleming, this port town from the Neolithic era can be found off the southern coast of Greece. Ancient pottery was discovered at the site, giving archaeologists the impression that the town of Pavlo Petri traded goods within the city and by the sea. According to Fleming in 2009, Pavlo Petri is thousands of years older than most of the ancient underwater ruins that have already been discovered. The estimated area of the town covers about 100,000 square meters, 1.1 million square feet. Its remote location likely preserved it from being disrupted by humans before the discovery. Neolithic pottery is one of the most notable finds in this underwater city. It provided a timeline for researchers to understand just how old these ancient ruins were. Originally, Pavlo Petri was thought to be part of the Bronze Age, but after further exploration, the city was found to be more than 1,000 years older than previously thought. Number 5. The Lighthouse of Alexandria. The ancient people were able to build gorgeous edifices, striking our imagination to this day. Have you ever heard of the Lighthouse of Alexandria, which is rightly considered to be one of the seven wonders of the world? It's also sometimes called the Pharaohs of Alexandria. It was built in the 3rd century BC and at a height of as much as 150 meters. The construction should have taken about 20 years, but somehow such a huge structure was built in just 5. Is there something to learn for modern builders? Right. The Lighthouse of Alexandria was built on the island of Pharos and was supposed to help ships pass the reefs. It seems incredible, but the light of the lighthouse was visible at a distance of 51 kilometers. Some sources claim that it was even 81 kilometers. It would be cool to keep such a magnificent building to this day, but the first destruction occurred in the 4th century because of the most powerful earthquake in the history of Egypt. Since then, the lighthouse has only been 30 meters high. By the 12th century, the bay was ruined to such an extent that nobody used it anymore. By the 14th century, the building was completely destroyed by another earthquake. All that's left to us today are a few fragments underwater. However, you can still see ancient writing on them. Number 4. Zemchug Canyon, Bering Sea. Found in the Bering Sea, Zemchug is also the deepest underwater canyon. With a volume of 5,800 cubic kilometers, 1,400 cubic miles, and a depth of 2.6 kilometers, 1.6 miles, Zemchug could fit the entire Grand Canyon inside it. It is so huge that it can only be seen in its entirety from space. Crazy, right? Submarines can travel through this deep sea site, as well as the different marine life found in the Bering Sea. Since Zemchug Canyon is so ridiculously wide, the entire underwater canyon can only be seen if you are above the curve of the Earth. So unless you have connections that can get you off Earth and into a spaceship, then you might just have to look at pictures. Number 3. Current movement of tectonic plates. The North American and Eurasian tectonic plates have been spreading farther apart in recent years as the North American plate moves westward. This impressive occurrence can be seen both on land and by diving deep in between the two plates near Iceland. This has been done by a number of underwater photographers and scuba divers. Alexander Mustard, in particular, is a diver and marine biologist who has explored this area and recounts his experience as an incredible one. He notes that visitors can become nauseated as a result of the sheer walls and clear water. Though the future cannot be completely foreseen, researchers can make predictions based on the current rate of plate motion, which is about 2.5 centimeters, 1 inch per year. Number 2. The Statue of Christ. Take a look at the 2.5-meter-tall statue of Jesus Christ, located in the Italian bay of San Fruttuoso, near Genoa, at a depth of 17 meters. Surprisingly, the figure covered with numerous algae is quite recognizable. What an amazing discovery, you say? Well, we thought so too, until we found out that the bronze statue of Christ was lowered into the water on purpose. This was done on August the 22nd, 1954, and the idea belongs to the Italian diver Duilio Merchant. The fact is that in 1947, his friend died in this place, and Duilio wanted to do something to immortalize his memory. He had the idea of placing a statue of the Savior and did it. Today, this place is popular with underwater divers. The water in the Bay of San Fruttuoso, though, is very transparent, so the statue can even be seen in the smallest details. By the way, Christ of the Abyss, as it's known, is not the only sculpture of this kind. There are two exact copies. One is on the coast of the capital of the Caribbean country, Grenada, and the second was erected in 1965 in Florida, in the United States. Number 1. Mars Warship. On May the 31st, 1564, the Swedish warship Mars went underwater in the course of the Northern Seven Years' War. No one knew exactly where this wreckage ended up. For many years, researchers have studied the bottom of the Baltic Sea, but they were lucky only in July 2011. It turned out that all this time, the ship rested at a depth of 73 meters, 10 nautical miles northwest of the Bertha Harbor on the island of Erland. Inside, bronze cannons as well as coins minted in 1563 were found. Divers who have explored the ship tell stories that are both amazing and horrifying. They say that this is not just a ship, but a whole battlefield, and when you dive, you almost physically feel the drama of what happened. On the day of the shipwreck, more than 1,000 people died in this place. It's amazing what discoveries water can hide for centuries. Thank you so much for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please let me know by clicking the like button. Do share, write a comment, and don't forget to subscribe so that you can catch up my next video.